reading comes from chapter 4, and it introduces the other two main characters in the book, Brother Billy and Becky Kay. Becky Kay climbed the three steps up to the trailer door and gave two knocks on it. A deep, strong voice echoed back, "Come in." A tall, well-built man was seated in a green and yellow lawn chair behind a nondescript card table. Jutting out from under the table was a pair of large feet housed in polished wingtip shoes. Upon seeing Becky Kay, Brother Billy's feet retracted, and in an instant he was standing tall welcoming his guest. His mouth immediately spread into a big, broad grin. Without taking notice of the boys, Brother Billy said, "My goodness, if it isn't Becky Kay. Why, just the other day you came to mind, and it started me wondering when I'd seen you last. And not 10 minutes ago, my man Derek, who works the gate, mentioned to me you were here," Brother Billy said in amazement. "It has been a good while," Becky Kay said wistfully. "It has at that," Brother Billy agreed. "Have a seat and make yourself comfortable," he said, beckoning her to a lawn chair on the other side of the card table. After she sat down, Brother Billy retook his seat and looked across the table at her with the same wide grin he sported a moment earlier. "Let's see now. How long has it been since you were here last?" Becky Kay gave it some thought and determined that it had been two husbands ago. She had a clear memory of it because her fifth husband, Edward Nelson, whom everyone knew as Ed Kirby and whom everyone called Buddy, had been having an affair with Thelma Hastings, whom everyone called Tally, at the Pine Tree Trailer and RV Park just outside of Baymanette, Alabama. A police officer had come to Becky Kay's door in the dead of night to inform her that a man and a woman had been pulled out of a Dodge pickup truck after it had hit a telephone pole at high speed. Both persons appeared under the influence. He had come to her house because it was the address on the dead man's driver's license. He mentioned that the female passenger had not had any identification on her. From the description of the body the police officer gave, she knew that it was Thelma Hastings, but said nothing. Even after peeking under the white sheet at the morgue later that night, as the police officer had requested, she still denied knowing the woman. Becky Kay met Tally when they both worked at the Piggly Wiggly in Brewton, Alabama. They became fast friends. Back in those days, both she and Tally could turn a man's head faster than a redneck could pop a top on a cheap can of beer. They looked so much alike, everyone thought they were sisters. And they shared everything like close sisters do, including the men they dangled around their fingers. But when Becky Kay married for the first time, those days ended, and Tally had the men she found all to herself. Years later, Becky Kay ran into Tally at the dirt cheap discount store in Lumberton, Mississippi. Tally was with a friend of hers, whom she introduced as Buddy, who was, as she put it, unattached. One thing led to another, and Becky Kay and Buddy married. It wasn't long before Buddy coincidentally found a job mighty close to the Pine Tree Trailer and RV Park. Becky Kay hadn't paid any mind to it back then, but now the truth of the matter seemed clear as day. A familiar-looking key was among Buddy's valuables that Becky Kay received after the accident. She recognized it immediately as the key to Tally's RV and hung it on a magnetic hook attached to her refrigerator door. It served as a reminder of Tally's betrayal. Every time the refrigerator was open, the heavy key spoke out. One day, not long after the accident, the key's depressing, dull moan got the better of Becky Kay, and in a near hissy fit, she grabbed it off the hook and drove over to the Pine Tree Trailer and RV Park. She returned home driving Tally's RV with her own car in tow. When Becky Kay opened the glove compartment of the RV, she found all of Tally's personal and financial information, including Tally's driver's license, RV registration, and insurance card. She opened a post office box in Tally's name and changed all of the contact information to the new address. From that day forward, Becky Kay made sure that the registration, driver's license, and insurance were kept up to date. No one ever questioned the picture on the driver's license, and the insurance company had no problem with a change of address or accepting a money order. She considered the acquisition of the RV to be a small compensation for Tally's betrayal. Becky Kay returned to the present and said, "I guess it's been about 2 years, Brother Billy." "Time does fly," Brother Billy remarked. "Derek said you're driving an RV. The old Dodge pickup finally meet its maker?" "In a manner of speaking, I guess it has. It left this world the same day that Ed died," Becky Kay explained. "Ed Kirby," Brother Billy said thoughtfully. "I remember the man. I'm real sorry to hear about his passing. He seemed a troubled soul. I hope he's found his peace in heaven." "I think he had already found his peace on earth." "So it was like that," Brother Billy said, nodding his head slowly.